What's up, fellas, and welcome to this new video. Today, finally, I'm making a long time request video, and it is, what is the easiest way to write a black metal song or metal song in general for beginners? So, since I always hated those videos where people speak too much but explain too little, I want to make this video faster but rich in content. So, the first thing, in my opinion, that a beginner has to know is what makes a song. There are six primary parts in a song, and those are the intros, verse, pre-chorus, chorus, bridge, outro. You don't have to follow those rules if you want, because a song can have a different structures, but since you are at the beginning, this is the best way. My brother, for example, can cover a lot of songs, he can write a lot of riffs, but he have a problem. He don't know how to compose a song. He can write riffs, but he don't know how to continue. He say, I don't know the structures of the song. I don't know how to compose a song. If you're a beginner, maybe you're struggling with that too. Maybe you're struggling with finding the first riffs. Maybe you have the first riffs, but then you don't know how to continue, how to build your song. So in my opinion, if you're at the beginner, the easiest way to compose a song is to have a drum track. It can sound strange, because usually you can say, yeah, but I'm a guitarist, I'm playing guitar, I take my guitar and I'm trying to compose a song starting with riffs. But trust me, if you have a drum track, it's much more easy. For example, the track that you listened in the beginning of this video is a track that I composed in 10 minutes. I took the drum for a program called Easy Drummer. It's a preset drum already written. I just took it and I composed my song on it. There's also another good program that we can use, it's called Superior Drummer 3, and those both programs came from a company called TuneTrack. There's already some presets that you can use, but also you can compose your own drums there, because it's full of fills and patterns that you can use. Maybe you're asking yourself now, yeah, but I can't afford those programs, how I can find a drum tracks if I don't have those programs? The answer is easy, YouTube. YouTube is full of drum tracks. Sometimes, if I'm lazy to compose my own drum or there's no preset that inspired me, I'm going on YouTube, I listen to some drum track, I choose one and I compose my song on it. Usually I'm doing this when I have to do those kind of show test on YouTube of a song or a technique or stuff like that, and I need something quickly. So I download the track, I compose my song on it, and then upload the video with this drum track. For give you an example, this is a song that I composed with a drum track I found on YouTube. This is the drum track. As you can hear, the drum is the same. I download it from YouTube, I load it on Cubase, and I compose my song on it. So if you can't afford any drum programs, the easiest way for you is to go on YouTube, download the track and compose your song on it. The good thing that maybe you will say, yeah, but I can't keep this track is already kind of mixed and stuff like that. Yeah, you need that to find the inspiration to start your song. So when you have finished to compose your song on this track, you can always delete this track and start to compose your own track. Or if you have a drummer, if you are not one man band, you can just use this drum as a reference and then delete it and send all the song, all the riffs you wrote to your drummer and say to him, look, put a drum on my riffs. The second tip that I can give you is to never start with lead guitar. It's much more harder to find a good melodies and then just add the rhythm guitar than find the good rhythm guitar and then write the melodies. If you have already a good rhythm guitar, it's so much easier to compose than your lead guitar on your rhythm guitar. Some of you ask me what kind of scale I use. I don't know. Sometimes when I have a drum track and I wanted to record something, I start to, let's say, to play in this scale. If it doesn't work, if I can't find anything that's satisfy me, I try up here, I try down there, until I don't find the start riff, and then if the riff is here, I'm just starting to building the song here, but then can move up there, etc. So it depends when you play, where you found your first riff, at least that's how I do. So always start with rhythm guitar. In my first album, Night Whispering Souls, I recorded a song called Evil Dead, and I started with lead guitar. It came out easier, but for the rest of my songs and even for the new album, I always start with rhythm guitar. It's much more easier. Also, when I record the rhythm guitar and the lead guitar, I usually record the left rhythm guitar, right rhythm guitar, and in the center part, the lead guitar. I know that there's people out there that record two left guitar, two right guitar, two guitar in the middle, and it doesn't work for me. First of all, because you add too much stuff, so when you go to mixing your album, it will be much more difficult for who will mix the album to get a good sound out from it. I don't need a tougher sound. Metal is already a tough genre, so I don't need more tracks. I'm already happy with my left, right and central guitar. I also play in the standard E. I think for me it's the best, work the best, first of all because I like how it sounds, I like the melodies that came out from this tune. Also, I love metal from 80s and I love the sound, and most, the majority band of from 80s playing in standard E, and also most of the black metal bands play in the standard E. I know there's band to play in the D, drop D and stuff like that, but I don't need a tougher sound, and to be honest, I don't like it. The third tip that I can give you is to listen a lot of music. Don't focus just with the same 2-3 bands. Don't listen just the classic like everyone do, like Mayhem, Emperor, Burzum, Darkthrone, because you will not get too much influences, and what you will play is a copy of those bands. For example, sometimes I'm going on this awesome page called Black Metal Promotion on YouTube, and they upload everyday new bands. What they listen, unfortunately, is that most of these bands, when they play rhythm guitar, they play always the same chords, and usually you can listen stuff like this, similar like this, every time. This is one of the common riffs that I always listen. And this is why those people never listen too much music. And this is something that don't came just from me. For example, I'm a drummer too. I have a DVD of George Collas, the awesome drummer from Nile, and he say if you want to be a complete drummer, you have to listen a lot of different drummers. And it's the same with guitar. If you want to be a good guitarist, be able to write a good melodies, you have to listen a lot of different bands to get much more influences as possible. So those are the main tips that I can give you. But I can give you a couple of tips more if you are a one-man band. For example, when it comes time to record the bass, what I'm doing, usually I record guitar, and then when I'm recording the bass, I follow the rhythm guitar. If you're not a bassist, it will be hard for you, you know, to compose your own bass line. So it's hard for me too, because I'm not a bassist, so I'm following the rhythm guitar, and that's all. If you have a bass, you do that. If you don't have a bass, there's an awesome program that you can use, and it's called Easy Bass. Easy Bass is a MIDI program where you can load your bass track in MIDI files, and the program will play for you. To do that, you can use a program called Guitar Pro 5, that it's a perfect for a noobs like me that don't know how to read the tabs. So basically you have a neck of your guitar in the program, and every time you press with your mouse on the button, will play it, and you can compose your song, and while you're doing this, the program will write the tab for you. So the only thing you have to do then is when you finish your song, is to extract it in MIDI file, load an Easy Bass, and Easy Bass will play with you. The sound, it's amazing. That's why for the first album, I borrow a bass from my friends, but for the second one, I'm recording with Easy Bass. The last tip that I can give you if you're a one-man band is for vocals, writing lyrics and vocals patterns. There are some musicians out there that start to write lyrics before they even have the song finished. I don't know how they do that, but for me, don't work at all. What I do, usually when I finish the song, I struck the song, and for the next days I listen just this song. During the listening, I'm starting to build the vocal punters in my head, singing no-sense words just to build lines that will help me when I will start to write the lyrics. When I found the right vocal patterns, what I do? I sit on my table, I take my paper, I take my pen, and I start to listen the song again, knowing already the vocal patterns that I choose, that I build in my mind, and I start to write the lyrics. In this way, in my opinion, it's much more easier because you are building your lyrics with your vocal patterns and with your song behind. So in my opinion, the way I'm doing is the easiest one. You have the track, you build your vocal patterns in your head, and then when you have it, you listen to the song, and while you're listening it, you start to write your lyrics. So guys, those are the tips that I wanted to give you. I don't know if those tips can help you, but this is the way I compose my music. It can work for someone, it can't work for someone else, but in my opinion, this is the easiest way. Unfortunately, since I'm not mother language English, it's hard for me to explain you some stuff in details. So for more detailed stuff, just write a comment in the comment section down below. So guys, this is all for this video. I hope that will help you with your composing process. And if you're new, please, if you like this video, subscribe. And for the rest, as always, see you in the next one. Cheers!